Fuck you, Byleth! Suck my dick! Fuck you. Suck my dick. You're dying! Well, they're both gone. They're out.
You've finally done it. The Ashen Demon is no more. Mm-hmm. You don't sound too pleased with yourself.
Yeah, I know. I know I should be. But now that it's over, I just feel kind of empty. What if all this was just some horrible mistake? What if there was another way we could have solved all this? Sorry. I shouldn't be dumping all this on you.
There's nothing to apologize for. You're processing a lot right now. I'm not sure what it means to be happy, empty, and regretful all at the same time. But I think I'm going through it myself, too. Though I wouldn't call it happy per se. More like free. Like, I finally finished a quest I thought would never end. The relief practically moved me to tears.
Hey, are you crying?
I'm not sure. But I do know this. I'm beyond grateful for everything you've done for me. I couldn't have asked for a better partner in destiny.
Same here.
Okay. All right, what's gonna happen?
I owe you a great debt.
Yeah, we really saved your skin. Though I'm sure you would have preferred to have us in your debt instead. Must really change that issue on the other foot.
And what is that supposed to mean? If all you plan to do is mock me, then perhaps I'll not honor the debt after all.
Hey, it was just a joke. Just something Warren said. Nothing for your imperial majesty to work about. Jokes aside, do you have a minute? Eager as I am to get back out there and chase down our enemies, we need to talk.
If you insist. What is it?
Right now, the Federation and the Empire are fighting together against the people. But honestly, I have no desire to see Fargus and Prince. I'm only after the Central Church.
At this point, though, wouldn't you say the two are one and the same?
I'm not so sure. When Dimitri decided to grant sanctuary to the Central Church, he really wasn't in any position to refuse. If he had, the chaos that ensued would have torn Fargus apart. But what if things are adding up differently now? It's clear the war will drag on so long as he continues to shelter. Besides, the Federation's Eastern Church and the Empire's Southern Church are both operating independent of Rhea's influence. The Central Church must be looking like a pretty heavy burden to Dimitri right about now. And hey, it's not like the kingdom wouldn't still have the Western Church.
Perhaps, but the Archbishop has far more influence in Fargus than anywhere else, even if Dimitri has changed his mind. I doubt those around him would be open to the idea. The fact remains that the kingdom has yet to show any sign of severing ties with the Central Church. They stand beside them even now.
This is just a theory. Well, actually, it's more like wild speculation. But what if the reason Dimitri tried to take Eric Mom was because he wanted to distance himself from the church. By facilitating Rhea's return to Garrett Mott, he could be trying to set the stage to break away.
That's an interesting theory. Do you have any evidence to support it?
Not really. That's the impression I got when I saw Dimitri on the battlefield. To be honest, it didn't even occur to me before now. He was so determined to take down Rhea in that battle, he never spared a thought for Dimitri's motivations.
I see. Had it occurred to you sooner, you would have had quite the decision to make about whether to leave me for dead. After all, if the Central Church was really leaving the kingdom to return here, abandoning me would have been the expedient choice.
Oh, come on, little guard. Sure, we've had our differences, but that doesn't mean I want you dead.
I'm happy to hear you say that, even if it is a lie.
No, it's not a lie.
It's the honest truth, from the bottom of my heart.
So you say. No matter. You should continue to do as you see fit, and I will do all I can to bring this war to an end.
Sounds like a plan. Let's end this war. Right now, that's all that matters.
I will pursue the kingdom's army westward, conquer Arya Road, and take control of Fargus.
And I'll go north, after the Knights of Ceres. I'll defeat Rhea and dissolve the Central Church.
Let us hope the paths we walk continue side by side.
And don't forget that you owe me for today, Edelgard. If our paths do collide, I'll expect to see that debt repaid.
Alright.
Golden wildfire. Feel the beginnings. The Federation successfully aids the Imperial Army, and together they pursue the Kingdom and Church forces. However, Claude's sole aim is to eliminate Archbishop Rhea. While Edelgard contends with the Royal Army, Claude and his forces go after the Church. In their pursuit, they arrive at the Tail Team Plains, where Seros and Nemesis battled long ago.
Hmm, interesting.
It's not much further to Kingdom territory. Once we cross the border, we'll march through the Tail Team Plains and make our way to Fargus. The Plains of Tail Team are the largest in all the Fargus. As I recall, they're also where a well-known battle took place long ago.
We're going by land instead of sea this time, huh? I have to admit, I prefer it this way.
We may have taken a wild little detour, but we're finally back to marching on the Kingdom capital.
Are you sure it would not be prudent to ask the Imperial Army for assistance? They certainly owe us after that last battle.
The Imperial Army is pursuing the Kingdom Army westwards. They're well on their way to Arya, but most of the Kingdom's forces have gathered in the west as well. Rhea and her troops are the only ones who fled north.
I don't get it. Sure, it makes sense for the Kingdom to reinforce their position on the western front. They're losing ground there after all.
But is the King of Fargus really abandoning the defense of his capital city and the church?
I can't claim to know what his intentions are, but I suspect Dimitri has decided to leave the rest to me.
What's that supposed to mean? What in the world could the king of an enemy territory trust you with?
I think I get it. Dimitri is counting on Claude. He's probably hoping to get Claude to rule the capital for a little bit.
What?
No, he doesn't gain anything by having his capital on. What he wants is for me to dissolve the Central Church.
Are you suggesting that the king wishes to avoid formally cutting ties with the Central Church and is therefore using us to bring about its demise? I have heard that the Central Church ended the kingdom when a civil war broke out. Perhaps Dimitri feels indebted to the Archbishop. His knightly values demand he not oppose her directly.
But that's... No. I suppose this is the nature of war.
There's more to it than that. The kingdom and the church have a long history, or the reasons why the king can betray them. Long ago, the hero Rune von Blathen cut down the Adrestian Emperor on his death. In fact, their battle took place on the Tail Team Plains, which we're just about to cross. The church mediated the conflict and recognized House Blathen's independence, leading to the founding of the Holy Kingdom of Fargus. As you might have guessed, that's how they got the Holy Kingdom.
So essentially, abandoning the church would mean turning their back on the very group to whom they owe their independence.
And that That's why Dimitri wants the fledgling Lester Federation to do his dirty work and abolish the church in his stead. That's my guess, anyway. But his reasons are immaterial, since getting rid of the church is what we've been after all along. He says that our future in the free world to come will tear down the central church and put an end to Rain. You can count on it. If they run off to Ferniak, just have to conquer the capital to get to them. That's what I like to hear. It's time to fling open the doors to a whole new era. All forces, advance!
Here we go. Someone calling? Hold on, I'll be right back, guys. Stay crispy.